Hi, I'm Daria Fissoun, and I'd like to welcome you to the Nobe OmniScope training series from Time in Pixels. Over the next few videos, we'll be going over the fundamentals of setting up and using OmniScope, as well as gaining a better understanding of scope functionality in the professional post-production industry. Let's get started. OmniScope is a powerful video signal monitoring application designed for professional colorists and digital imaging technicians. It's used worldwide on everything from high-end television and film productions to short-form media and web content. Its many tools include advanced features that are not often found in native NLE scopes. It's also highly customizable and supports a wide range of workflows. OmniScope is designed for colorists working in industry-leading grading applications like DaVinci Resolve, Baselight, and Scratch. Is designed for DITs who specialize in on-set video capture. And with its built-in NDI support, OmniScope is also used by video editors on Avid Media Composer, Premiere Pro, and Final Cut. It can even support photographers and still image editors using Photoshop and Lightroom through screen capture functionality. Due to its broad software support, we recommend checking the documentation linked in the description of this video for detailed information on how to set up OmniScope for your workflow. In this video, we'll focus on DaVinci Resolve, but the accompanying videos in this series will be relevant no matter which host you use. The simplest way to send your video signal to OmniScope from DaVinci Resolve is to add its OpenFX plugin to the Timeline Node Editor. When you launch OmniScope, you'll be prompted to select a connection. Click DaVinci Resolve, and your signal should immediately appear in the scopes. Check the Effects panel settings to configure your image format, the timeline color space, image scaling, and frame rate. Another way to set up your video source in OmniScope is by using the Connect menu at the top. In the Pro version, you can set up multiple connections by going to View, Show Input Strip. Right-click any of the available thumbnails to select a new video input signal. Here, you'll also be able to globally reassign which signal is displayed in the scopes. OmniScope will automatically detect your color settings, and so the source signal should match what you see in the Resolve Viewer and Scopes palette. If it does not, you have the option of overriding the color settings by going to the Connect menu, to DaVinci Resolve, and Settings. Disable Automatic Color Settings Detection, and choose from the list of presets, or manually set up the color space standards using the Color Management drop-down menus. As well as setting up OmniScope using the OpenFX plugin, you can also run OmniScope as a standalone app through an I/O card such as Decklink, Ultra Studio, or AJA. It can be set up to run on the same machine or even a separate CPU. The benefit here is that you'll be monitoring the same outgoing signal as the reference monitor, meaning there will be no risk of misconfiguration in Resolve. And if you choose to run OmniScope on a dedicated machine, you will also see improved performance in DaVinci Resolve as a result of it having full use of the GPU, which can be especially felt when working with UHD and HDR projects. One of the biggest advantages of using OmniScope is the level of customization you have when setting up your workspace. To begin, go to the Scopes menu to open a new scope window. When you start dragging it, highlighted areas will indicate where it can be docked. Docking allows you to fill up your available workspace with optimal scaling of the tools. Every section can be partitioned as many times as needed to allow you to fit all your scopes. The global appearance and behavior of the scopes is configured in the input settings and the preferences. The individual scope settings can be accessed by right-clicking any scope. The upcoming scope videos in this series will look at these settings in detail. When you are done setting up your workspace, you can save it in the layout menu. You could choose to have multiple scope configurations, perhaps based on project type, user, or monitor resolution, to name just a few possibilities. Use the menu or the Alt Option modifier to switch between workspaces, save recent changes to an existing layout, or reload the layout you're currently in. There are many ways of interacting with the scopes using shortcuts, most of which will be covered in the individual scope videos. But here are some universal commands you should know about. Press the Tab key to toggle the menu bar and scope tabs. This will result in a cleaner, even more optimized workspace. And you won't see the dock and drag lines anymore, meaning you won't accidentally make changes to your scope placement. press Option, Alt, and F to toggle to full screen mode, removing the header at the top of the application and further cleaning up your workspace. Press Option, Alt, and S to solo the scope that is currently under your mouse cursor for a more detailed view of the trace or image. Press Option, Alt, and G to grab a snapshot, and Option, Alt, and B to toggle it. This is commonly done during grading to compare shots from the same scene or when trying to emulate a look from a reference image. We've only just scratched the surface of OmniScope's many powerful features. Make sure to keep watching to get detailed instructions on how to best use the waveform, the vector scopes, the CIE plot graph, and many other crucial tools. There's a lot of great info also to be found in the official documentation, so check out the video description for that. I'll see you in the next one. We'd appreciate if you could like this video and subscribe to the channel for future training videos and to stay informed about new developments in OmniScope.